Hey everyone, and welcome to our healer tier list update. This tier list has been put together using the latest beta patch with the knowledge and experience of our rank 1 consultants. This means a lot of what you see may be subject to change. What this tier list will offer though is a first look at what's doing well and why when it comes to PvP. We'll continue to update these tier lists as needed throughout beta before releasing a solidified version once Shadowlands Arena Season 1 begins. Before we get started though, if you're as excited for Shadowlands as we here at SkillCapped are, then be sure to drop a like and subscribe to our channel for more up-to-date Shadowlands content. For this tier list, we'll be placing our healers into 4 tiers. C, our lowest tier, ranging up to S, where we'll have the best of the best. On screen now, you'll see a quick refresher of how our earlier tier list shaped up in its last rendition. Well, since then, there have been a few buffs and nerfs, and the meta has gone on to further establish with players figuring out the best builds and compositions for their spec. Without any further ado, let's jump into the bottom of our tier list, starting with our C tier. And still remaining in that C tier, and probably as no surprise to anybody, we have Holy Priests. Holy Priests have received a lot of new additions, including Mind Blast, Power Word Shield, Shadow Word Death, and even new PvP talents in Divine Ascension and Cardinal Mending. Sadly though, these are still not enough to push Holy Priest into the right direction. Holy is honestly more focused around PvP, having raid CDs and AoE healing, which just doesn't have a place in Arena. Previously, we saw Holy Priest do well more so in 2v2 thanks to greater heal and ungodly amounts of haste thanks to Corruption. Well, with the removal of Corruption and high levels of haste no longer being achievable, combined with the killer 15-second CD attached to greater heal, Holy is well and truly out of the running. It just lacks the damage reduction, and strong healing Discipline Priests are capable of, so unless we see very impactful nerfs to Discipline, there is nothing Holy does better, giving us no option but to place it in our lowest tier once again. Alright, that's going to be it for our bottom tier though. And moving up to our B tier now, we do have a spec that's moved up one position on our tier list, going from C to B, and that's Holy Paladin. Our reasoning for Holy Paladins being in our bottom tier previously was for a few reasons. The biggest of all was their loss of borrowed power. If you experienced BFA, you would have known how Ineffable Truth made Paladins the S tier healer that they once were. Well, with Corruption gone, they for sure lost a lot of their strength. What's made things even worse though is the addition of a mini rework, with now Holy Paladins going back to a resource called Holy Power, which they can build up to spend on Word of Glory. While this isn't a terrible design, it came at the cost of a huge nerf to Infusion of Light. The way Holy Paladins used to deal with consistent pressure was to pair up Quick Cast Holy Lights with the PvP talent Light's Grace. Despite many new additions such as the return of Saved by the Light, Hammer of Wrath, and even Concentration Aura giving your whole team an Aura Mastery, Holy Paladins' healing is just far too weak to combat the burst damage of Shadowlands Arena. So, back to the point. Why have they moved up a slot on our tier list? Well, Holy Paladin struggled with throughput more than anything, and with the beta being out longer now and top players trying out more things, it's widely agreed upon that Avenging Crusader, commonly referred to as Melee Wings, greatly aids to gloss over a Holy Paladin's flaws, giving them burst AoE healing and good damage. Although this comes at a very high mana cost, the fast-paced state of Arena allows Holy Paladins to play very bursty cleave compositions and rotate defensive CDs to survive during the downtime of their Avenging Crusader, aiming for short games where their powerful defensive cooldowns can make up for their lack of throughput. All of this is also on top of a very nice buff to Holy Shock, having its cooldown reduced to 7.5 seconds, down from 9, which again only helps to improve their throughput. This results in a very big adaptation and a nice buff, having pushed Holy Paladins up one tier. Moving on, our next healer on this list is quite the opposite though, and has dropped down one tier. Previously being placed into our A tier, we have our second addition here, which is Mistweaver Monk. Initially, Mistweavers were in a very strong spot. Despite having the least changes out of any other healer, they still had decent throughput, strong legendaries, and a great Covenant ability. Well, the two things making Mistweavers stand out was, first of all, their incredibly strong legendary Tear of the Morning, which did 50% of the healing of your Vivify and Enveloping to targets you had just cast Renewing Mist onto, making Mistweavers' healing absurdly strong. This was more often than not your top overall healing inside of an arena setting. Well, Tear of the Morning had its healing cut in half, now only doing 25% of the healing of your Enveloping and Vivify. This is a very big blow, which means Mistweavers actually struggle with throughput now. The second change that's caused Mistweavers to drop down a tier is a nerf to their extremely strong Covenant ability, Fallen Order. This Venthyr Covenant ability did both strong damage and also healing. This ability suffered a nerf to instead spawn a monk every 3 seconds instead of 2. So Mistweavers are left feeling practically the same spec from BFA after having all of their strong new additions heavily targeted. So with Holy Paladins moving moving up a tier and Mistweavers dropping down, that's going to conclude our B tier. Moving up to our A tier, now we have another spec that has moved up. And our first and only addition to our A tier is going to be Restoration Shamans. Many players expected this spec to struggle due to the removal of Pack Spirit. Well, in our first tier list, Restoration Shamans were doing okay, placed inside of our B tier. What they struggled with was nerfs to Tidal Wave, alongside relatively weak new additions focusing primarily on PvE. What Restoration lacked was any form of instant strong healing. Outside of their cooldowns, Earthen Wall, and Spirit Link, it was hard to heal players up without having to hard cast abilities and risk getting interrupted. Well, thanks to a huge buff to Riptide increasing the initial healing by almost twice the amount, this means that Restoration Shamans have had their weaknesses glossed over, being able to do the majority of their healing with Riptide and Earth Shield, especially when paired up with the legendary Earthen Harmony. Alright, so let's quickly recap our updated tier list so far. Our previous tier list looked like this, and so far our new one is looking like so. Before we get into our S tier, if you're enjoying the video so far, a sub to the channel would be phenomenal. So we've reached the moment that you've all more than likely been waiting for, our final and strongest tier, the S tier. These specs are currently the strongest and best performing healers on the beta. And first up, still maintaining their spot in our S tier once again, we have Disc Priests, which is surprising considering they've had the nerf hammer thrown at them in almost every beta build, including nerfs to their damage, rapture, legendaries, and even soulbinds. Well, even despite these nerfs, Disc still remains to be without a doubt firmly placed into our S tier. Incredibly high damage for a healer, great utility with Power Infusion, Dark Archangel, Life Grip, Mind Control, Thought Steal, the list goes on. Very strong passive healing from their Atonement and even great single target healing with Shadowmend on top of strong defensives like Pain Suppression, Rapture, and Barrier. Even if they adjust the numbers even more, I feel Disc will always have a spot in our S tier for Arena and PvP in general. Their kit is just way too strong. Last but not least, the biggest change of all on this update is Restoration Druids climbing up two tiers. I think this was honestly to be expected though. Resto Druids have one of the strongest new kits on the beta. The addition of buffed affinities and Cyclone baseline, along with many great new and returning abilities and talents, meant they always had potential. The one complaint we had previously about Resto Druids and their biggest downfall was their lack of healing throughput, combined with just how easy they were to focus down and kill. Seeing as how the meta was developing into a very bursty place, Restoration Druid's way of healing and dealing with damage was not best accustomed to it. Well, since our last tier list, Restoration Druids have received buffs to almost every one of their heals. Life Bloom, Cenarian Ward, Rejuvenation, and even the PvP talent Reactive Resin have all seen very large buffs. We've also based this choice a lot on how the meta is playing out. Restoration Druids make for great partners with Shadow Priests, a dominant caster. Shadow is able to make up for Druids' lack of defensives with their utility, a Life Grip, Void Shift, or just the added shields and heals allow Resto Druids to play to their strengths. So, with Resto Druids joining our highest tier, our completed and updated tier list now looks like this. We saw a few specs moving up on the list, one moving down, and the rest staying the same. Alright then everyone, that's going to be it for this healer tier list update. For more information on all of the healers featured in this tier list, be sure to check out our up and coming overviews, featuring all of the information you need to know to get started ready for the release of Shadowlands Sinful Arena Season 1. And as always, if you want to remain up to date with our Shadowlands content, be sure to like this video, ring that bell, and hit that subscribe button. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.